Zombie Apocalypse. Okay, now we are going over what I think now is the best run stopper. I used to like the 4-4 split. Now we're in the 4-6 normal. And before you pick the play, press your right stick to the right once, because you want your speed package in. That puts deep more. That takes out two linebackers and puts in defensive backs. So now you're just faster all over the field now in this formation. And now we're doing the same play. It's the cover two invert. Now we'll go against like tosses. Let's do a halfback stretch. Now what you want to do is baseline. Then you want to also, there's cloud flats. You want to play hard flats by hitting Y or triangle down on the right stick. Then you're going to take this guy, bring him down, but also put him in a middle third, just in case they pass. And I would QB contain L2 R1 and user either of these yellow zones. I like this guy because he's a safety in a linebacker position, because you got more speed on the field now instead of just using a linebacker in the like we do in the 4-4 split formation. So just baseline Y or triangle right on the D-pad. Play the hard flats Y or triangle down on a right stick. Bring him down, put him in a middle third, and QB contain L2 R1. And you're faster because you're on the defensive back now, which I like so much better. Look at that. This will stop mostly every run. I'll show you a different run. 4-6 normal speed package. Cover 2 invert. Let's look at the outside zone. So baseline, play the hard flats. Bring him down, put him in the middle, and put him in the middle third. QB contain. Look at that. He's got nowhere to go. This is better than the 4-4 split cover 2 invert. They got nowhere to go. Look at that. So it's that easy. I think this is better than the 4-4 split cover 2 invert as a run stopper. I love this 4-6 normal. So this is the run stopper out of the 4-6 normal speed package. Okay, now we are going over sort of a coverage play out of the 4-6 bear, because you don't want to just use this to blitz or stop the run. We are going over the 4-6 bear wall stunt, but before you pick the play, you want to put the linebacker rush package in. So just use your right stick until you see the LB rush. Now we're going to the wall stunt, and I don't know. Don't use this against shotgun. I mean, that's obvious. You want to use it against single back or anything like this. We'll try level switch, but I'm going to show it to you against a running back blocking and against a running back not blocking. Now, there's two ways to set this up. We're going to do a first straight up coverage play and then sort of a blitz. Now, what you want to do is just spread all linebackers right on the D-pad, up on the D-pad. QB contain, which is L2, R1. Then you want to take this left of screen D-end, but because of that linebacker rush package, he is a linebacker. You want to man him up on the tight end, which is Kelsey. And if you want,
only if you want, you could put one of these two linemen in a QB spy. And I would use her, this guy, this linebacker, in the middle of the field. And look, nobody gets opened. Eventually somebody will, but because of this formation, you might get a block shed pretty quick. So spread all linebackers, QB contain, and man up this guy on the tight end. So it should look like this. This is four-man rush. Help him cover the tight end, then get anything underneath the middle of the field. Then if nobody gets in, you know, they might have to throw and whatever. But what you're going to do here now for the blitz, sort of a blitz anyway, you want to slant the D-line to the right, QB contain, blitz this guy, and then man up. The same thing, man him up on the tight end. So it should look like this. Against a blocked running back, sometimes that will happen. You'll get a decent pass rush. So slant the D-line to the right, QB contain, put him manned up on the tight end. And you could use your quick adjustments, R1 twice, square, and then down on the right stick to blitz him. And you'll get a decent pass rush from that. Just like this. If you want to use or control him and cover the middle of the field, because the middle of the field's going to be open. I mean, I'm not talking like this is like the best nano blitz, but this is just a pretty good coverage defense out of this formation, which you can send the blitz from. So the ending setup's like this. Let's take that halfback off of his route, off of his blocking assignment. And you're going to have a much better shot of that coming in. So you want to surprise your opponent with this. This is the ending setups. So it's just a little blitz, not a nano blitz, but it's good 1-2 punch with the coverage play and also a sort of a blitz from this wall stunt out of the 4-6 bear. Stay tuned for the next play.
Okay, now we got another defensive tackle. I don't even know. It's a defensive end nano blitz. And those of you that have the 3-4 defensive ebook, we put defensive tackle A-gap nano blitzes in. This is kind of the same technique. Those of you that don't know what I'm talking about, we're going to get into it. So 4-6 bear will pick the cover 3. And this is best against under center plays. It can work against shotgun, but it's not as good. And it doesn't matter if a blocked running back is blocking, running back's blocking, or it doesn't matter. Now there is a technique. What you want to do this play is shift the defensive line to the left, which is left on the D-pad twice. Slant the D-line down or inside, which is left on the D-pad down on a right stick. And then just take this linebacker. Is he a linebacker in this formation? Yeah. Just bring him down in this gap right here. Now you're going to put this defensive end on a QB spy, which use your quick adjustments, L1 twice. His icon is circle. And then left on the right stick. Bring this guy down here. Make sure he's not offsides. Now the technique part of this is, now you're going to take the right stick and just keep pressing it down until they snap the ball. Because this is a QB spy, when he's on a spy, or when anybody's on a spy, if you want to send them towards the quarterback, you hit the right stick down. You click it. So in essence, we're going to do that and get a defensive end nano blitz. And it's kind of tough. It's something you want to practice. Because, look, even I didn't get it. So left, shift the defensive line left, slant them inside, put that circle on a QB spy, the right of screen, the end, bring him down here. Now keep clicking the right stick button in. And look at that. That is what you're going to get. It is insane. It is, I guess it's a glitch. I mean, it's not even a glitch. It's just, look at that. Look, it's insane. Insane. So that's the technique. You put one of these guys on a QB spy. You got to come close with another guy and keep clicking that right stick button in. So now, it's not going to work all the time. Also, if they, let's say, slide protect to the right, I'm going to try. It might pick it up. You see how that is? So this is something good that's good for like one or two times a game. Just let your opponent know that you have this. Use this in critical situations. You know, catch them off guard with this, because it is so deadly that they're not going to want to have this happen to them. Oh, I put him in a yellow zone on accident. They're going to keep looking for this, especially if you set this up the same way and come down to the line here. They're going to know what you're doing, especially if you hit it with him. You hit it on him. You threw this at him once or twice. I mean, look at that. It's sick. So it's not the most consistent thing, play, but it does work. Works in game. You know, it's mainly against under center, but it's so super easy. Now, you could look, even now, I'm going to do the opposite. Shift the defensive line to the right, slant the D line inside, put the left of screen D end now in a QB spy, and then bring this linebacker down here and do the same thing. Click the right stick. So what you want to do is just throw them off a little by switching sides. And it works better in a formation like 4-6 bear, because it's such a condensed set and you got like six people on the defensive line. So that'll just confuse your opponent's offensive line. So you could do this from either side. Sometimes it won't work. I'm not saying it's the most consistent thing, but you see how good it is when it does work. Oh, I did the wrong thing. Let's see if it works with two spies. So that's why I like to do this from a coverage play from this formation. In case it doesn't work, you got still some guys coming into coverage. Look at that. So it's the 4-6 bear cover 3, defensive end, A-gap nano blitz. Stay tuned for the next video.